Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. We have a narration from Imam al-Sadiq alayhi salam in which he tells us, يَنْبَغِي لِلْمُؤْمِنْ أَنْ لَا يَمُوتَ حَتَّى يَتَعَلَّمَ الْقُرْآنَ أَوْ يَكُونَ فِي تَعَلُّمِهِ. The believer should be such that he does not die having not learnt the Qur'an, or at least to be in the process of learning it. The Qur'an is accessible to every single human being from every civilization, every age group, every culture, and every background. It was not specific to a certain people because it is the fitrah, the innate nature of the human being which understands the light, the words of the Creator. And so it was not sent down for specifically an Arab. There have been many saints within this religion that were not Arabs or could not understand the Arabic language. And so Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made an opening for the Qur'an in that it traveled the entire world and was translated into all these different languages for all people to be able to access it. The condition of wanting to understand the Qur'an is only to sincerely want to understand it, and then the opening will happen. However, saying that, the barakah of the Qur'an, the true Qur'anic experience, cannot be emulated in another language because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent it down in Arabic. إِنَّا جَعَلْنَاهُ قُرْآنًا عَرَبِيًّا. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has established the Qur'an as an Arabic Qur'an. In the same way that prayer and dua is recommended in any language, but the formal prayer, the ritual prayer, has to be in Arabic and in Qur'anic Arabic. Likewise, that barakah of the Qur'an in the Arabic language cannot be emulated in a translation. And so the true experience of it must be in the same way in which Rasulullah had recited it to his companions in that same tongue. So this Shahr Ramadan, we should take it upon ourselves to try to understand the Qur'an in its original language, in its original form. And if we were to dedicate only 30 minutes a day to towards the steps of understanding the Qur'an, then in 6 to 12 months, we would be able to comprehend it and read it in its original form. And we could take 3 steps in order to make this happen. The first step is for a complete beginner to understand and learn the alphabet, the Arabic alphabet, and the movement of the tongue in which to pronounce those letters. The second step, after the first step has been completed, is to learn the vocabulary of the Qur'an. And this can be done without having to learn the entire Arabic language. It can be done through just a list of the vocabulary of the Qur'an. About 300 words make up 70% of the Qur'an. So you could do that in a matter of a couple of months because those words are often repeated throughout it. The third step for those who are learning at a more advanced stage is to learn the basic Arabic grammar of the Qur'an in order to string those sentences together and make it flow. So that inshallah, this would be the beginning of our journey of understanding and experiencing the Qur'an in its barakah and presence, in its spiritual presence. And by the next Shahr Ramadan, if God gives us life, we would be able to read and understand the Qur'an in the language it was revealed in. Walhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen wa sallallahu ala Sayyidina Muhammad wa alihi at-tayyibin at-tahirin.